Called Hillrom in the US, and they make hospital beds and a large variety of hospital beds. And that's where I saw this bed called LDR bed, labor delivery recovery bed, you know, which you see upstairs. And I saw labor delivery recovery suites, which are very different kind of a suite. And that's when I thought that giving birth to a child for a woman is such a happy event, something which she really likes to enjoy and celebrate. And being in a hospital is a very odd thing. You know, a hospital does, you know, life and death kind of surgery, and everybody is very, you know, depressed and very gloomy and all of that. So I said, no, we need to create a place which is a very different kind of a place, which can do safe delivery, but which offers opportunities for the mother and her family to really celebrate and enjoy. So birthing is not a sickness event. This lady is not a patient. And today, either you do it in a large hospital or you do it in a small nursing home. And small nursing home, you know, we have the concern that will it be well equipped, will it have well trained staff. And a large hospital, like I said, gets very worrying, very depressing, because that's what a hospital is. So we said, can we do a different thing? And I created the cradle concept when I was with Apollo Hospital, and it did very well. And there are a whole lot of other people who have copied the same model in different places. So I said that how do you create a more premium version of the cradle, something which is a lot better, a lot superior than what the cradle has been. The cradle was about the place. You walk into the place and you think, oh God, place I want to deliver here. And we said, can we create a place which offers a lot of personalized experience, you know, whether the mother is treated like an individual and everything is personalized for her. So that was the idea. And we would have spoken to 120 women who have either delivered their first or second child or were pregnant. And we spoke to their husband, some of the other family members. And we found a lot of things. One of the things we found, when a woman is pregnant, okay, in fact, most of them today, you know, you have nuclear family. So fortunately or unfortunately, you don't have your mother-in-laws with you and you don't have your mother with you. So there's nobody to counsel. So they have a lot of anxiety. They keep on hearing different things. You keep on Googling and you keep on worrying all the time that what all can go wrong. And you need a doctor and you need people to reassure you, answer your question, make you feel less worried all the time. So anxiety we found was one big area. Then we found that they wanted a lot of convenience for all the right reasons. For example, today, if you go to a large hospital and a woman needs an ultrasound scan, she may have to wait for an hour or two, which is not a good thing. So what we said, you want people and they would like to be, you know, in a very, very convenient environment. So we said, how can we make the place much more convenient? Then, like I said, very, very personalized, you know. See, when you deliver a child, you're not sick, you know. I mean, you want to have a certain kind of food, you want to enjoy, you know. So we said, then how can we make the place very, very personalized? That was very important for us. How do we get the family involved? I mean, in the Indian context, everything is about the family and friends. So when I become the mother, somebody becomes father, somebody becomes uncle, somebody becomes aunt, somebody becomes grandfather, somebody becomes everything. It's a family event. So how do you get the family involved? Today you go to a large hospital and you get visitors' passes. You get one, and if you know somebody, then you get two. That's it. So we said, no, we don't want to be like that. We said, we want to get the family involved. So we even have counseling session for the family. So when a kid is born, the father needs to know a lot of things. Okay, I mean, today's environment, even the mother needs to know a lot of things, the grandmother. The olden days, the grandmother will say, eat a lot of ghee and butter and all of that. Today, the young girl will say, I will eat nothing of that kind. Are you with me? So even the grandmother needs to be educated, etc. So we think it's a family issue. It's not something personal. So how do you address that need? To inform them all the time, people to take care of their anxiety all the time. So we said that if the idea is to address what they are talking about, we will deliberate, we'll do a place which is deliberately very small. So I'm not saying small in terms of size, I'm saying small in terms of capacity. So if you notice here, we have not tried to push small, small rooms here and there. You will see a lot of space. So such a large building has only 24 rooms. If you and I go around Hyderabad, you will see a 100-bedded hospital in such a place. Am I right? In Amirpet, a lot of places. But we didn't want to do that. So I said, it's a small place, but very spacious, very pleasant. It is not supposed to look like a hospital. It's well equipped like a hospital, very well equipped, but not look like a hospital. Okay, we focus only on obstetrics, so we do deliveries primarily. We do other procedures as well, but primarily delivery. We have very good newborn care. Okay, we have used technology very, very intensively. Okay, great food, no visiting hours. Okay, I mean, the man who made it, I mean, it's like the guy who made the girl pregnant, the least he should do is to be with her at the time of delivery. So, you know, so we actually, I'm not even saying we allow, we insist that the husband should be there at the time of delivery. I mean, there have been people who said, Mr. Jalan, I can't see blood, you know. So if it's going to be cesarean, then I'll faint. And we say we have a doctor, so if you faint, fine, somebody will look after you, but you better be there, right? So we wanted that to happen. Just to give you a sense that, see, again, the good thing is in India that we have 120 crore people and we produce 2.4 crore children every year. That's, you know, I mean, 2% is the birth rate. That's like the population of Australia. That's what we do every year. So it's a big market if you see. It is about 11,000 crores if you look at OBGYN, that market. Like I told you, that 120 crore people. Okay, even if I forget people staying in rural areas, I talk only urban, about 35%, and I talk people who stay only in large cities, even then you're talking about 84 cities and 15 crore people. So I'm saying you have about 30 lakh deliveries which happen only in these select cities. And what I've tried to do is to say that if you take income classification, so I've deliberately used the word people who are pretty rich, let's say SECA, platinum spoon, gold spoon, silver spoon, steel spoon, and pardon my language, but no spoon. Okay. So I am saying that if you look at the market which is only for the affluent class, even then it's a very, very large market.